I got into this industry 6 years ago since I became licensed, 8 since I became a student. But why I come out to these events and why I do what I do is because I'm very passionate about this industry for a few reasons, and I'm sharing with people. Before barbering, I was good at one thing and one thing only. I was convinced that nobody could beat me at it. It was quitting. I often say I was a professional quitter. I tried every industry. When I say every industry, I'm gonna give you a little bit of a rundown. I worked at Starbucks for 2 weeks and I never came back. I was a masseuse for a month and I never came back. I worked at the LA Zoo for a day and I never came back. So doing all of that, quitting all the time, I felt like a big failure. And when barbering came into my life, I was actually afraid to pick it up because I didn't want to quit at something else again. And I got myself to school, aside from everything that my mind was telling me. And when I got to school, my school not as nice as this one, but when I got to school, everything about that place felt right to me. I knew that barbering was what I wanted to do. And barbering for me, what it represents is opportunity. How many of you guys feel like that right now? Make some noise. Barbering didn't care about my background. It didn't care that I grew up in South Central, that I was the middle of 5 kids to immigrant parents. It didn't care that I was a woman. It didn't care the tone of my skin. It didn't care that I had no skill set. It didn't care that I hadn't finished anything else before. It was just an opportunity to build something for myself, an opportunity to learn a craft that I could take anywhere and everywhere, irregardless of whether I spoke the language there or not. I started with zero, I started with nothing. I started selling 12 t-shirts out of the trunk of my car. I started by buying a ticket, just like you did today, and participating and making myself known. I started by competing. I always say that my career was short-lived because I competed once and then I retired. But I retired from competing to produce my own competitions. I mowed down barber exhibit. How many of you guys heard of mowed down before? You know, when I used to ask that question, there was only one person that would make noise, and it was Joey back there. She works with me. We started with 100 people, guys. Last year, we saw close to 1,000. We started with no sponsors. Last year, we had over 30 companies. And you know those companies? They weren't big companies. They were companies that were artist-owned, like the ones you see here today. What do I mean by that? Other barbers and hairstylists that saw an opportunity, and instead of just sitting on the sidelines, said, I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna bet on myself, and I'm gonna do it. We hear so many things about our industry, so many people have opinions, but I always say this, you cannot identify a problem without wanting to do something about it to fix it. So I always leave everyone with this message. If there's anything that you feel our industry is missing, build it. If you feel that there's things that you can make better, do it. Do what you can with who you can. Work with the people that support you, even if they're perfect strangers, because the people that you came up with just don't recognize you anymore because you've changed, because you're growing. That's what this industry is about, and that's what's happening here. It's about our ecosystem, that we need each other, that we need the companies and the schools and the products and the events and the barbershops and all of those things. How many of you guys own a business today? Raise your hand. How many of you guys want to own a business one day? Raise your hand. Look around you. You're gonna need each other. One day you might need a barber for your shop. One day you might need to get a barber license, whatever it might be. And your resources are gonna come from this industry. I've been very fortunate that in 6 years, I've been able to go from cutting hair in Compton from $10 to working in places like West Hollywood, to traveling to different parts of the world. The furthest I've been to is Russia. And if you would have told a Mexican kid from South Central LA that somebody would buy them a ticket to go to Russia, to a place where they don't even speak your language, just because you're passionate about what you do and because you picked something up that you love and you didn't put down anymore, that to me is my message. So I hope that today you walk away with a little something of value, that you go home with something else in your arsenal to keep you going, if nothing else, just a motivation of seeing other people out there as hungry as you, dedicated to what they want to do and making their mark in this world. So thank you guys so much for being here. San Diego, I have so much love for you. I always make the drive all the way from my LA bright and early. That's why I have bags under my eyes and I change my hat to hide a little bit there. But I have a lot of love for you guys. I have a lot of love for my my industry, and I have a lot of love for this community. And the more I see people putting out products, new brands, new this, new that, starting organizations, putting on events, listen, there's enough room in this for everybody. And if we know how to coexist with one another, this can grow even bigger and bigger. The world is looking at the American barber culture as influence. So you guys are the ones that are making all the moves and all the changes and everything that's happening in our industry. So I appreciate every single one of you, and I always believe in leaving something behind wherever I go. So who wants to be a winner? Can't come up here. Let's give it up for California Barber and Beauty College. I've been doing this consistently for you guys. Not only like making barbers licensed and professionals, but giving them opportunities like in their industry. And I see these guys like as a family just everywhere. And let me tell you this. A lot of people look at that traveling barber lifestyle and it looks real nice because all you see is a 15-second video of a 12-hour flight. But it's a lot of work, guys. And if you want it, it's up there for you to grab. But I really want to commend the people that have been doing it. So give it up one more time for California Barber and Beauty College. We have some giveaways. All right, who's ready though? All right, so I'm gonna do a little by little. Hold that for me. We'll do the good one at the end. Well, they're all good. Just say that. All right, we got our buttons, our collector's buttons. One time, let me hear it. The guy on the phone, he was literally the kid from that Justin Timberlake like performance. You guys saw that? Everybody's live and he's just like, who's Louis from Barbers? Like, hit him with the meme, somebody. All right. We got our collector's pin, ready? Now, let's have them, collector. Come on, come on, DJ, give us some music, give us some peace, come on. Let's have them up, ready? Here we go, collector's pin. One, two, and three. No, that's it, I'm not gonna fight him right now. He was going to this guy. All right, Barber Society t-shirt, who wants it? On three, one. Show them what we got. Farmer Society.
They don't
want
it.
Limited. They don't want it. Farmer jacket. Oh, he's going to wear it for you. Bam. All right, give us a little spin. All right. Now flash it with the red. Bam. Oh, I don't have red. You have red. All right, this is for the jacket. Ready? All right, you guys are going to have to get out. Ready? Now this person in the room. Here we go. On three. One, two. One. Hold on. It's a red time. Down the middle. It's a red time. And the other three. One. Oh. Yo, but you got at least buy a beaker. Thank you guys so much. My name is Louie. If you have any questions, see me at our booth. Thank you so much for having me.
Give it up for Louie Barber Society.